You ready to fire into this?
We left off with Oklahoma?
Yes, we did. That means that the next up will be the Oklahoma State Cowboys. 2018, they went 7-6. Not great by any stretch of the imagination in Stillwater. They were 3-6 in the conference. They got 5 offensive starters returning, 5 defensive starters returning. Experience-wise, number 53 in the country, number 5 in the conference.
I was just about to say, I'm going to bet they're right in the middle of everything.
Right dead in the middle, yeah. Head coach Mike Gundy had 3 straight 10-3 seasons after the last 7-6 season, which was in 2014. Surprise, they went 7-6 last year. Does that mean 10-3 this year? We shall see. The new offensive coordinator, Sean Gleason, from Princeton, he will involve more quarterback run option type stuff. And he is fascinating to watch. I mean, Princeton is unbelievable. What they did, they were just insanely creative. Really insanely creative. Perfect for redshirt freshman quarterback Spencer Sanders. Running back, Chuba Hubbard. He returns, one of my favorite players, both in name and the fact that he just runs hard.
I was about to say, he's a punishing running back.
Yes, he certainly is. Defensive coordinator Jim Knowles, his first defense was all over the map. They were number 112 in total D. I'll tell you this, after they destroyed Boise State, I really thought, okay, there's that Duke defense. There's the attacking, wild, just bananas kind of defense. And then it just kind of, who knows, it went poof, nothing happened. Either he didn't understand the personnel, or
I think they got into Big 12 play.
Well, or he asked them to do something that they could not do.
They just hadn't learned the schemes, I guess, as well. The offense is, so I give the Big 12 a lot of crap all the time about just not playing defense. A lot of it is not only that they don't play a lot of defense, because a lot of these teams don't, but the offensive scheming in the Big 12 seems to be substantially surpass everybody else in the country.
Yeah. No, you're right.
That's where, like, the most innovative offenses, man.
Well, I'll say this. Are coming from, with Sean Gleason coming in, it's going to be even more crazy,
that's right.
Which means Knowles has got to find a way to even stop the guys in practice.
Well,
right?
He didn't really have to worry about that. Agreed, he's not going to play against this offense.
No, but
nobody in the Big 12 is going to run like what they're running. So he doesn't really care.
Although I think that some of them will. It'll just be,
he's got to find a way to stop Oklahoma and Texas.
Yes.
That's what he's got to do.
You are exactly right. Year 2 in Knowles' defense should be better. The non-conference is light. The schedule should reach 8 wins roundabout. Go on and tell me first what you think.
I got him 8-4. I wanted to have him higher. I like Gundy a lot. I like the trend where they have a down season. He always kind of bounces back. And I don't know that they're going to get to double digits.
Oh, I don't think so.
I'd love to see it. It wouldn't upset me if it happened.
It sounds good, right? I mean,
but I got them 8-4.
The last time they went 7-6, they had, you know, 3 straight 10-3 years. I'm not seeing that with them this year.
Yeah, that's a little too much to ask, I think.
Yeah, Oklahoma State, I've got them at 8-4.
Okay.
I've got them beating Oregon State, McNeese, and at Tulsa. I've got them losing at Texas. I think this is a big-time game for Tom Herman.
Yep, I completely agree with that.
Beating Kansas State, I've got them losing at Texas Tech, because I would expect them to win that, but it's a road game. I think Matt Wells is a really good coach. I got them beating Baylor at home. I got them losing at Iowa State. I got them beating TCU at home. I got them beating Kansas, at West Virginia, and a loss to Oklahoma. Now, they've got Oklahoma at home, but you got to do it regularly for me to think that.
This is where I disagree on that. I'm not saying they're going to beat Oklahoma. I'm not definitively saying that at all. I think this is a year I think they can catch Oklahoma. You get them at home, and Oklahoma's coming off of, this is the first year we're actually going to see what Lincoln Riley's all about.
Now,
this is his team completely. We talked about that when we did the Oklahoma breakdown. I think there's going to be chinks in the armor. I think there's going to be holes in there somewhere that you can exploit. That's your biggest rival. You've been bullied by him for the last several years. I just think at some point in time, the bullying stops.
Okay. I can understand
that. To assume that you don't beat them all the time, which means you shouldn't beat them, is wrong.
Okay. I do understand that aspect of it. However, if they're going to beat Oklahoma, you had them at what, 7-5?
8-4.
Oh, you had them 8-4 as well. I had them 8-4. So where else do they lose?
Well, I mean, I don't think it's impossible for them to lose to TCU. I don't think it's impossible for them to lose at Iowa State, Texas. And I just assume that they are.
I guess Baylor. I mean, they've got Baylor at home.
They are the type of team. This is one thing about Gundy. He always finds a way to lose a game he shouldn't lose.
That's true.
I mean, you got him losing to Texas Tech.
Yeah.
I don't have him doing that. But, I mean, if they beat Oklahoma, they could easily lose that game.
No, you're right. You're right. You're 100% right.
So
that makes absolute perfect sense. So, all right, move off of them. We both got, oh, their over-under, by the way, is 7.
Yep. So we got them going over.
The over is -130. The under is +110. So, of course, Vegas sides with us. It's more likely they go 8-4 than 6-6.